I want to share with you briefly on how great is our God. That's the title for my sermon this morning. How great is our God? Now, as Christians, we tell people how great and awesome our God is. You know, when people want to talk about, oh, God is awesome. God is great. But listen to this part. But when God puts us in situations to show how great and awesome he is, we fail him. You know, when we're not in the situation where God will deliver, God is good. When we're in the situation where we're like, I don't know what I'm going to do. It's like we just forget. We spin around in such a quick time. But listen, we fail him because of faith. This morning, I want to encourage us on this topic, how great our God is. And I'll be asking this question throughout the message. So, how great is our God? And if you need to see the scripture verses, they're on the bulletin as well. So, how great is our God? The first thing I want to say is, he's greater than our fears. Oh, wow. Well, you know, for me, I fear a lot of things. the things that scribble on here. When they come about, I kind of forget about God because I'm too busy running. Well, I should bless God because the legs work so I can run. But God is greater than our fears. Listen, many times God is calling us as individuals to do things for him. Especially sometimes, like, he calls us to go on missions trips. He calls us to help someone in need in our neighborhood. He might even call you to go to Bible college to do some studying. And you're like, whoa. But you don't go. You know why? Because of fear. I remember when God said to me, I should come to the United States to study. Now, if you know anything about me, my sister is here, she can back me up. I'm a logical person. So if I'm going to do everything, the plan has to be written, and everything has to be set out on the plan. So I'm going to do this by this month, I'm going to do this, and then the outcome is going to be this. How many people know God doesn't work that way? So, you know, we have a saying that man is planning, but God has the eraser. So, I had everything planned out. So even this last one, he called me to come to Bible college to study. At this age of my life, and I'm like, what? But fear set in. But I decided not to let fear win, and I went in faith. Now, whatever we do, we need to understand that even though we are afraid, if we have faith in him, he will see us through. In 2 Timothy 1 verse 7, listen what the scripture says. For God has not given us the spirit of fear. What? We were created with the spirit of fear. We did that all on our own. Man came up with fear. God never created us with the spirit of fear. Listen what he created us with. He created us with power, love, and a sound mind so we can think for ourselves. But we put fear in the mix. Look at that. So we need to exercise our faith in God. When he calls us, we need to answer, and our faith in God will overcome our fear. You just need to trust him. Secondly, how great is our God? Well, he's greater than our problems. Woo! I'm glad he is, because problems are with us every day. Look at Lori. She was good last week. We were on the phone talking. Everything okay? Yeah, everything's fine. Next thing I know, she broke her foot. I'm like, what did I just talk to her? Problems come, and you don't know where they're coming from. We will always have problems, right? We will always have troubles. But guess what? We will always have God. And that's where we forget to put him in the mix. We'll always have situations coming up. We'll always have problems coming up. But God never said he was going to leave us when we were having these problems. He said he was going to be with us. We need to remember, regardless of our problems, we can turn them over to the problem solver. Can you imagine? Everybody talks about the great minds of these worlds. You know, when, what was that time? Ben Carson did that surgery. Remember that big surgery that separated the twins? One of the best minds in the world. But guess what? Ben Carson has problems too, just like anybody else. But the one who created the best minds in the world is our God. And we're worrying about problems. Whatever it is, he can solve them. He will give us the strength and the grace to go through whatever we face. Wow. Look at what the scripture verse says in 1 Peter 5 verse 10. And it says, "And the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while," he didn't say you weren't going to go through. God was honest. He said, "After you suffered a little while, will himself what? Restore you and make you strong and firm and steadfast." Wow! Look at that. So we go through stuff to make us strong, to make us firm, to make us steadfast. And when all of this is going on, God is restoring us. Look at that. I think I need to face a lot more. Sometimes we don't see what God is doing in our lives, but he's doing stuff. So the next time you have a few problems, look up and say, "Okay, God, what are you showing me? Am I supposed to learn something from this?" Because when you go through the problem, you're restored, you're made stronger, you get firm, and you can help somebody else go through what you've been through. So never forget that. Third and finally, how great is our God? He is greater than the unknown. Wow. Yeah, because guess what? There's no unknown to him. There's unknown to us, but there's no unknown to him. So, there are many unknowns in this life. But the biggest one that freaks a lot of people out, what do you think it is? Death! You scared to say it? It's the truth. The biggest unknown that most people are afraid to even talk about is death. You know, they were saying, everybody wants to go to heaven, but nobody wants to die. But that's the only way you're going to get there. It's funny, but it's the truth. You can't get there without dying. That's how it goes. So, the fact is, we all have to die. Whoa. The other fact is, once you die in Christ, your unknown is sure, as our God is greater than death. But where are we worrying? Can you think about that? We have a God that is greater than death. Yet still we still worry. Oh my gosh, this is so funny. But listen to Philippians 3 verse 20. Look at this verse. This verse is very clear. It says, "But our citizenship is in heaven." Oh, let me stop right there. You mean we're citizens of somewhere that is not even on this earth? Yes. Isn't that awesome? When you put United States on the map, every country that has a problem and is suffering, where do they try to get it? The United States. Everybody wants to be a United States citizen because it's free speech. Nobody's going to kill you. You're safer here. So they try to come here to become a citizen. But look what the Bible says. But you are citizens of heaven. That means all of the persons who have already trusted in Christ got their citizenship papers. And you don't even know it. We're citizens of heaven. And it says, "And we eagerly await a Savior from there, the Lord Jesus." So when we go to our next plane in life, after we die and we transition, we're going to go and meet up with our Savior. And we're here fighting to stay alive.
The ticker isn't working too good, but it's still got about 10 years.
Listen, citizenship papers are in heaven, and God is greater than the unknown. Don't fear because someone has not come back from the dead to tell you how good it is. That's the thing, you know. That's why it's unknown.
Did you see Charlie? Oh, yeah, I saw.
How can I see Charlie? He died 3 years ago.
Oh, well, I heard he's having fun up there.
Nobody has that report. We just have to go to see for ourselves, right? For a child of God, we are sure that our unknown is in Jesus Christ. And for that fact, we should always rejoice. Because God is greater than the unknown. So in conclusion, to answer the question I've been asking, how great is our God? Right? He's greater than anything we can think of. So in our Christian life, let us act and behave and live like we serve a great God. Because in fact, He is a great God. And that's our message for today. And today, I want you to sing a song just to get this book.
Not me, all of us. Let me correct that real quick.
So you look at the back of the bulletin, we see how great is our God. And we're going to sing it. All standing. And we're going to sing this one out.